There it goes. All right, we got an opponent. And I guess I have sounds disabled or something. Settings. Alerts. Play. Do I not get sounds during the game? Enable sounds. There we go. Now you can hear it click. All right, so it looks like I'm hanging my pawn b to bishop takes. This is not hanging a pawn at all. This is, in fact, a trap if he takes it. Two different ways that's a trap. But we don't need to go there because he just moved his queen, wasted a tempo, and now I have kind of a free hand to do what I want. He's going to play h3 at some point, because it's just a really predictable move, and there's not really a whole lot else he could be aiming for here. Okay. I don't have to fear this bishop, so I'm just going to castle. So I'm taking every tempo to move a different piece here. Minus the one I spent on h6, because I actually like having this knight placed in this position. So h6 was kind of a half-wasted move, but it stops the super annoying bishop g5 pin, which makes white's pieces useful. And I mean, bishop g5 is also a pretty predictable move. Whereas now we've got a more random position that's a little trickier for white to deal with. Do I dash my knight up to f4? If I try that, he's probably going to play g3, but I don't know that that's something for me to avoid. Yeah, let's keep advancing my pieces, right? I know he's going to play h3 sometime. I don't know when, but I know he's eventually going to play it. So, we did castle opposite sides. I already control the center, so I'm going to expand my control kingside wise. Okay. He did not, in fact, play h3. He's just trying to win my pawn in the center. Bit of bad news for him is that I've actually protected that, but I instead chose to hang my pawn there just to make the game exciting. We'll go with that. But no, I think I'm doing well. I think my queen and my knight are placed to give mate in a few moves. And I don't know what he's doing. Obviously, if I play queen d7, it's all over. But I'm gonna avoid getting myself checkmated on the spot. Instead, I'm gonna form some threats. They aren't so easy for him to deal with. Obviously, rook g3 is called for here. But I don't know. This rook looks really awkwardly placed. I am sort of threatening taking on d3. Meanwhile, my opponent does have threats too, so I can't just completely ignore what he's doing, like I've been doing. Well, we have to kick this knight. It's gonna hurt. It's not gonna hurt him, it's gonna hurt me here. So, I guess I run, run, run. I'm dropping all of my pawns. I seem to have underestimated my opponent. Okay, I can't allow the double check, so I have to pin this. It'll show me for trying to be instructive, right? I should just go for cruder, cheaper attacks and not try to do anything building up to an attack. Because whenever I build up and try to do something strategic, it usually falls apart. Okay, so h3 is open. Might as well use it. I suspect he'll just take my pawn. I'll take back. I'm threatening queen e2. Obviously, rook f1 is the counter here. Don't know if he's going to find it. He's up material, isn't he? Okay. Well, let's just keep trying to break this open. It's not going to work, but I can try. Here, he should just be playing a4, a5, a6. There's not a lot of subtlety here. So I'm still down 2 points. If he plays h3, I can regain one of my pawns and still be suffering quite a bit. All right. Thankfully, I do have an increment. It's not going to help me very much, though, because my position's busted. I'm playing this because, well, I was going to say because the alternative I'm losing anyhow. Oops, there. Yeah, now he just plays queen f5. I'm forced to trade against my will. Take that, take this. Maybe I can hold. It looks pretty awful. Starting to look better. Oh, let's double check. I'm screwed. That's a discover check, rather. Yeah, I can resign that. All right. So, well played, buddy. He's a good opponent. I lost 68 rating points, apparently. My opponent's not taking the rematch offer. So I should just seek somebody else. I'm not sure what went wrong. Although on this site, computer analysis, as far as I know, isn't free. Also, doing post-game analysis is a pain in the butt. So I'm just gonna elect to try to play another game. Let's see. Let's pick somebody out of here. Computer 4 impossible. Computer 3 hard. Oh, hey, look, we got an opponent. Okay. Got a modern going here. I'm gonna just convert this into a dragon if I can. Although, perhaps I goofed up on that. Is this a dragon? It looks very dragony. Although my knight's, I'm confused. I want to call this a dragon. Okay, I support my center. I attack. Oh, I'm getting forked. Fantastic. This is complicated. All right, I'm gonna sack a knight for two. Obviously, I've played this incorrectly. I'm just gonna get all my pawns taken away. But in the interim, maybe I can get some counterplay. These guys on this side are really good at pawn counting. You don't get to that rating without being good at that sort of thing. Okay. So I'm preventing knight d4. Of course, he's just going to play knight b4 instead, and I don't really have a counter to that. Or at least, yeah, I'm forced to play bishop d3, a move I don't want to play. But there's nothing I can do. I do have a passed d pawn if he takes this. So, it's not all sour grapes. Or it's not all, I don't know, terrible. Let's not mix our metaphors. I have successfully trapped my bishop. And I'm getting crushed down the center. I guess this prolongs the crushing the longest. So we're gonna try that. However, now I'm dropping my f pawn. Maybe he won't notice. Just kidding, he's gonna notice. But maybe I get some counterplay. Oh. I guess the right way for him to proceed there would have been taking g2. So it appears I'm gonna lose a ton more rating points. I'm not sure. Perhaps I'm just that much out of shape, and this is just serving. Oh, he's got bishop h6. I didn't see that. Well, let's get out of that. Yeah, perhaps this is just serving as a friendly notice to me that I've got to get back in shape as far as chess goes. Okay, so now if he does bishop h6, well, he doesn't do it. Okay, if he does bishop a2, I've got rook a1. Gonna get my pawn off the same color square as my bishop. Let's try to trade down and maybe get into an endgame that might be tenable. Shoot. Oh no. Well, that's no good. I guess this is forced. Oh, he's got rook c1. I was counting on bishop g4 here. But yeah, rook c1. This is over. Well played. Do you want some more of my rating points? Because you're more than welcome to them. Okay, fine. We'll find somebody else. All right. Maybe I should try playing without commentating, or maybe I should try slower time controls, because these guys are monsters at these openings. Like, they actually know what they're doing. And obviously I do not. So we're gonna play something to just stop the bleeding. Just get a decent position and stop going for cheapos every game. And then maybe go back to cheapos later. But yeah, these guys are resourceful, much unlike the opponents that I've had in recent days. It's really giving me a workout. I did not expect this. Check. Oh, crap. Yeah, I allowed that move. It's okay, but it's more complicated than this needed to be. So this is loose. My center's kind of weird, but I am gonna get my knight out of there safely. And then I'll worry about playing decent moves. Oh yeah, no, the Lee Chess interface kept making me lose on time and not accepting my moves, so I decided to improvise. We're playing on a site that looks a little bit different than Lee Chess. Okay, so I can't take that. Guys on this particular site are pretty tactical or tactically aware. So what do I do? I guess I have to just retreat back to d1, let him take. I could play knight c6 and chomp his a pawn, and we're okay. Oh, knight c6. Yeah. I was looking for that idea in some positions. I wasn't looking for it in that particular position, but it's there. Okay. Well, we've got an end game on our hands, and this one's not going to be of the fun variety. Not unless he plays some ridiculous bishop move that hangs the rook. Maybe I should consider playing. Well, all my pieces are on pre all the time, so there isn't much time for me to maneuver them around. Wait, rook c8, king g7, rook g8 checkmate. That looks acceptable to me. That's hilarious. You don't see that every day. You force an opponent to look for a good move, they will find it. I had my back to the wall there. I had to find something, so I did. If he had played something a bit less aggressive, maybe I wouldn't have looked for that. Although, arguably, I wouldn't have that move either, but. Wait, how does all this stuff go again? I know usually once they move their bishop, I just bring my queen out, and it's fun times. Just let the shenanigans happen. So now I'll go back, and I like my position. Sure, it's awkward, but I like it. What are you gonna do about my hole on e6? I mean, I guess he's intending bishop e6, so I have to address this right away. I can't just ignore it. Do I sack an exchange? If I do, I get some interesting compensation, believe it or not. Well, no, I've already sacked it. There's no saving it at this point. So, there, let's take the diagonal. I don't often play here, although maybe that might change. This does seem to be a lot more responsive in terms of blitz games, and these opponents seem to at least give me a fight. So, I don't know, it's a bit more of an adventure playing here. Granted, it's a lot harder to find an opponent, but once you've found an opponent, it seems to work pretty well. Just take the center. I did not expect him to do that immediately. Like, my knight wasn't going anywhere, so why take it? Is there some advantage to trading? Yeah, Leech Chess, I was playing a blitz game, and I had like 10 seconds left, and I played a move to win the game, and instead Leech Chess dropped my connection. And it's like the second or third time in a couple days that that's happened, so, I'm not sure what to say. Other than that, that's just what happened, so that's why I'm playing here. Can I play e5? Pawn takes, bishop takes, bishop takes. Bishop has no useful discovery. I can't play f6. I can prepare e5. And he has to play something like queen c3 to stop me from pushing it. Takes, bishop takes, rook takes. I mean, this is the best I got, so we're gonna push it. Either that or I could turtle up and just pretend that I can salvage a draw somehow, but that's not realistic. Maybe queen e6 would have been better. So getting invaded here. Oh, here we go. This is where I counterattack. Check. Check. Counterattack begins. Probably gonna end poorly, but it has to begin somewhere. Take the open file. No, don't want to do that. All right, I'm gonna hit your rook because I don't have anything else to do. Let's protect this. I'm just astounded by his inability to find critical moves. Like, you find so many good moves, and then the one position where you get to find just one accurate move to set put the win away, just completely whiff. I mean, how can you whiff so badly? This should not be a position that I'm able to hold. And here I am, almost winning it. Moving that rook was a bit premature. Oh crap. Wait, no, that's covered. That was covered. That same idea did occur to me, but I actually calculated it. Whereas my opponent, who has got 2 minutes on his clock, still hustling and bustling, he must be in a rush of some sort. Okay. Your move, buddy. King d2. Oh, okay, he doesn't fall for it. He's gonna actually force me to use some technique to win this. But, I've got technique. See that technique? Sure, I'll take that. Take one of those. Go back. It is rook, and e3 is still dropping. Sure, let's just take this off the board. And the rest should be pretty elementary. Check. Oh, he doesn't even have rook b3 here, which would be the normal attempt to try to hold that. Check. Okay, we'll just keep pushing the pawn. There we go. Okay, we'll just keep pushing even more. Do the rook lift. And just rook f2. And follow that with king move. And I mean, that's GG. Okay, he finally concedes. I would say that was a really stubborn defense on his part. But yeah, these games are actually a lot more interesting than the ones I've been playing in recent days or weeks. So maybe I'll stick to this more often. Or maybe I just need to play slower time controls on the other site. So we got a Nidorf. I'm gonna play my line against the Nidorf. I guess now we're in hedgehog territory. Not sure what to do about that. Maybe I should take c6 in that kind of situation. Yeah. He who hesitates is lost, and I'm hesitating quite a bit. Alright. This is generally a thing in a lot of Sicilians, so I guess I'm doing that. I mean, any site that has me on, it's the best site in the world. I know, right? By the way, if you do challenge me on this site, sure, I'll play. I'm just playing some 3-2 here, so if you guys want my rating points, you know where to find me. Alright, so this knight c4 idea always seems to catch me by surprise. I always try to find some way to counter or prevent it. There really just isn't any magic sauce here. I have to accept that knight c4 is happening and do something about my awkward center. Let's get rid of that discovery. It's pretty uncomfortable. Yeah, now what do I do? Oh, I could actually stop knight c4 in this one very particular instance. I have a way to stop it. Well, we'll put it this way. If I make it down to 1601, we'll just call it a day there. So I've got knight d5 here. Not sure if that's good or bad. It sure looks ugly. That can be said for sure. But yeah, I think either way, his queen's gonna move somewhere, and I'm taking this bishop. I guess I didn't count for it. He could move the bishop to defend the queen. Although then I've got knight e7 check. So yeah, his queen is gonna move, and I'm gonna get to capture that bishop. Check. Okay, so I could follow with c4 if I want to. Unfortunately, I can't play c3 and support the c3 pawn, so I have to play it to c4. This does make a weakness on b3, however, the weakness is difficult to attack. There's only one open file, so let's just put all two rooks on it. I was gonna say all the rooks, but there's only two of them. And if I play f4, he plays knight g4. I can't. Knight g4. I mean, f4 is. I don't know. There's gotta be good squares for my pieces. And all my pieces seem pretty awkwardly placed here. Surprisingly, my knight's not in a very good spot, so we're gonna reroute the knight. I know he's not forcing me to move it, I'm electing to move it, but e3 is such a better square than where it stands right now, because it stifles both d5 and f5. Yeah, the one thing about the knight on d4 is it did stop a fork on f3. But now with my knight on e3, I could play f4, and maybe have some attacks and stuff. Okay, so let's put the pawns on dark squares, starting with that one. Didn't take a genius to see that this knight a5 was coming, but there was no way to stop it. This is where things get complicated. Okay, I do not take twice there. Instead, I take once, and then push a5, and I have a protected passed pawn. Plus his pawn's on a light square, which he doesn't want because he has a light squared bishop, as do I. Oh, right, about that protected passed pawn. Might not be so well protected after all. So I have to settle for this. Still, this is fine. Okay, sure, yeah, let's trade. I'll just keep pushing. Not sure how to follow. I guess I'm gonna oppose this rook, and the way by which I'm opposing it looks a little bit awkward, but this should work out. I did fall for a fork. He sacks on g2, then takes my pawn. It's actually a pretty terrible endgame. Oh, well, I mean, there's this. That's interesting. So I am seeking to complicate this a bit if I can. But yeah, this endgame's not so good for white. All I can do is just activate and centralize my pieces. And even some of that I cannot do. So we're gonna take that H pawn and deal with the consequences. Because if I don't take the pawn, I'm just lost. Here I'm probably lost, but that's different than just lost. It's a very nuanced distinction. Yeah, no, I think maybe I'm holding this after all, because this king's pretty far away from this pawn. If he didn't spend so much time pushing it, maybe he'd have something here. Free pawn. Let's go back. King f2 was possibly more accurate. So we'll do it that way. Let's go back here. Gotta keep my king close to these pawns. And if I'm pushing for a win, I play king h3. I hesitate. Because I really don't think I'm winning this. I'll try to complicate it. Okay, this king has to be on f3. This has to be on a7. We're slowly getting a more accurate picture of where things have to be. Actually, this has to be down here to stop a check. And we push. This king on g7 is not so well placed. I mean, we can both attempt to make each other overpress. Very clever. You got me. You got me, buddy. That was pretty sneaky. Oh, I had to play rook e7 there. I missed it. Oops, well that was not so bright. Maybe this does hold. Oh right, the rook's defending the pawn. Alright, so we get our draw. That was quite an adventure, was it not? Misplays tend to happen in time pressure. You might not believe that, but we saw plenty of misplays here. Yeah, one thing you'll see if you ever see my tournament games, and I think I've shown some of my tournament games on stream after the fact, some sort of post-mortem, is that I'm pretty tenacious when it comes to endgames. I don't just roll over, I do try to make it interesting. We saw this position, we saw this Trompowski the other day on Blitz Chess. What was... Oh, although in Blitz Chess there, we saw a different variation for sure. Presumably e6 is still playable, even though this is not the same variation. Okay, what am I missing? I still haven't decided where any of this is going to be placed, but I think I've gotten equality out of this opening. So now my bishop's defended, enabling me to castle. He's going to play... No, he's not. Never mind. So much for me predicting my opponent's moves. I'm not doing very well on that front lately. Yep. So, this is really well placed, stopping d5. I guess I have to... Well, I don't want to trap my queen. What else can I do? I've got rook d8. I've got b5 here. Yeah, this actually looks like the way to go. Though it seems to lose a pawn. The more I look at this, it seems that in multiple ways I'm losing a pawn. So yeah, b5 was probably incorrect. Bishop d5 threatens to take c6. I guess I have to play bishop b7. If bishop takes c6, bishop takes c6, queen takes e7, bishop takes g2. Okay, and while I'm looking at all that, he just makes a sub-ultimate in one threat. So we're gonna stop that. I guess bishop d5 and bishop b7, even though it lost this bishop, potentially winning the rook for my other bishop. Not sure how that would have all played out, but apparently it was okay for black, just given my opponent's choice. Well, do I push b4? If not, then how am I going to make use of this really awkward c pawn? Here we go. And I wager that if he takes c takes, I could even do knight takes and sack my rook, and maybe take that rook in exchange for it. We didn't go that way. All right, so I kind of have to defend this after all. Defending d7 lets me play bishop b7. All right, so he's going back and hitting f7, which I just weakened. I have to defend it this way. Except now I'm losing exchange, if not more. So let's get some action for that exchange. Or activity. Okay. This position just looks really awkward. I've got weaknesses left and right. Him, not so much. Let's get my bishop to a safer haven. See, do I take here? Pawn takes, bishop takes. What else am I doing? Not a lot. All right, we're gonna go for it. I can't exactly take that, can I? All right. Well, that's not awkward. Okay. I guess I go back here. I've dropped my c pawn. I'm not even getting anything back for it. I have to take. Oops, that's no good. I found a legal move. I seem not to be winning this. I seem very much to not be winning this. Down to exchange and two pawns. Is this something I can hold? Not if I go down a third pawn. Okay. Oh. Right. Oops. That's no good. He found it. Yeah, I made a mistake there. I needed to play like bishop f6. That's not gonna hold. If I drop my bishop, that's over. Although I was losing the bishop anyway. There wasn't any way to really hold that. Guys, this is not Lee Chess. I'm not 2300. I might be good at endgames, but the rest of my game could use some help. So we got a Caro Kann. And we got a fantasy variation Caro Kann. So this is one of the more fun Caros for white, in my opinion and experience with it. I'm up a pawn, which is not supposed to happen in the main line. Oh, okay, so I'm not remaining up a pawn. This is really awkward. Still exciting, but. Hey, look, I didn't see that that was going to be check. Hopefully, I get something for this. If not. Well, then I've just given up a rook for nothing. And that's not very good. No, I'm sure he's a perfectly nice guy. There's no need to be throwing names like that. Well, I got some stuff for the queen, or for the rook. This has turned out a lot better than most of the times I hang a rook in the opening. I've actually gotten something for it. My goodness, I don't know how I'm supposed to play. In fact, I'm thinking that the way my opponent played this opening looks pretty interesting. Oh, is this what we're doing? Oh, he did move. Okay. I thought that that particular move was fairly obvious, but. Maybe it's just really hard to come to terms with. Okay, so I've got F5 under my domain. That might provoke him to play G6, although G6 isn't the best move ever. So let's just develop the rook. Nonchalantly do this and wait for him to move that knight. I jest. There's more to it than just that, but okay. I see he's going for an equally subtle threat. But my point is, I don't care how subtle or how obvious the threat is. If it's effective, it's effective. So make use of it. I'm putting all my pieces on useful squares. I am developing. Hopefully not hanging anything yet. One thing that's awkward here is I don't have a second rook to counter on the e-file, so I'm going to need to move my pieces around to cover some more squares. Okay, I did not expect that. What if I just play my king here? I think he takes, I take. He's got knight g4, I've got king g1. He can get his rook to e8. Okay, we're not doing that though. So I'm just going to stop knight g4 before it happens. That's just one less thing for me to worry about. I've been avoiding attacking down the center here because I don't think it's going to be effective. Although, if he keeps playing these shuffling moves, maybe I will be able to just smash through. But yeah, this is a difficult imbalance to play with. Okay, so I'm up 2 points. This is scary, but okay. Oh, I'm actually going to win another pawn. I did not see that. So let's get out of the fork with tempo. He keeps trying to exploit this position of my king, but his bishop's on the wrong square to do any of that. Okay, now he's found a better square for his bishop. But it's just one bishop. So I'll just defend it this way. I might have to play knight f1 to cover the e3 square. Oh, knight f1 doesn't look so good anymore. Yeah, this whole position looks really awkward. There's no avoiding it, though. I have to go here. Alright, that too was unexpected. Though, everything's still fine, but knights are tricky pieces. Let's just tuck away over here, right? Where do I go? If I go here, the knight d3 is awkward. So I have nothing better than this. I'm afraid of doing this because he's got rook e2 in his future. But what else can I do? Oh, crap. Okay, he missed it. Let's get out of that. Actually, I don't know that that escapes it either. Let's go back. Okay, I'm gonna push this, because my position's weak everywhere else. It's actually kind of strong on the queen side, so I have to play my strength. Yeah, he has knight. No, he doesn't. Knight e1's covered by my queen. I'm not sure. He is clearly having a very strong attack there. I think he had the better position through most of it. Yeah. Poor guy. But that happens in Blitz. A lot of people play 5-minute chess. I play 3-2. But this is actually quite a ridiculous pace to be playing the game at. Because so much will get missed, there's no avoiding it. Part of why I'm missing so much is because I'm trying to explain my thoughts, and that just consumes energy and time and effort. Alright, let's sidestep this. By sidestep this, I mean the d4, d5 advance that follows after c3. Thus pinning my knight and winning material, or at least giving me double pawns. I'm just gonna sidestep that whole thing. The thematic moves bishop g5, however, I see he doesn't want to play it. I don't know why not, because it's actually pretty good, but I guess he wants something different today. So now I play bishop b6 once he hits the bishop, and then I shuffle my other knight to f4. I'm gonna do this with tempo. He might be considering dropping the bishop back to c2, which is a way to play this. Not everybody's favorite way, but it is a way. I'm gonna counter this bishop. I don't care if he doubles my pawns. Well, no, part of the reason we have weird openings is because I play weird openings. I find ways to get us out of book because opponents know way more book than I do. So I force us onto some kind of neutral turf where we can play chess and tactics and endgames and things. I sack. No idea if this is going to work or not. I say that from a knowledge standpoint. I did look at this very briefly before playing it, and it seemed okay. It's not like I found that, oh, this is refuted, I'm not going to play it, but I'm not so confident in it. Okay, we're just going to bring up more forces in this attack. The more things I can hit the side of the board with, the better. So let's see if I can get the whole army involved. This does. Well, I guess he's winning a pawn, because I'm going to let that go. So I'm gambiting a pawn or two to try to move this attack forward as fast as possible. I do have ideas of knight f4. So we're just going to keep going. Let nothing deter us from attacking. Other than like the attack completely bombs, then maybe that'll deter us a little bit. But okay, I see he's intending queen takes g4, so I have to do something about that. I've got knight f3, so he stops knight f3. Let's think. Does it matter which square I go to? If I go there, I don't have knight f3. So I'm just going to go for the more centralized square here. Looks like my attack is bombed. So let's see to what extent I can bail out into an endgame. How much did I sack to get this? I think it was at least a pawn. If king g2, I have rook f2. King h1, I've got knight takes f2. Well, either way, I've got rook f2. If king g2, do I have knight f4 also? King g2. I'm not mating him here. I wish. It's not there. See, it looks like no matter what he does, rook f2 is my best move. Still hesitating on if king h1. I still might want to just do knight takes. Although my knight has nowhere to go next. Okay, my opponent disconnected and reconnected. He's rejoined the chat. Alright. Let's see how far I can get here. Rooks belong in open files. That's a free knight. Though this position's. Oh, never mind. This is check. If this were not check, this would actually be quite dire for black on account of b4. I have to play this to break up his pawns. Let me do this to hit them from behind. Okay. And I need to keep doing these things with tempo while his king is too far away to take my pawn. I can't wait. I have to keep acting with tempo here. This is closest to my king, so I'm gonna let that stand there. Now, hopefully I don't get mated. Hopefully I find a way to promote while not getting mated. Okay, I've been playing quite hastily here. I didn't think the pawns would get this far advanced. Rook f1's the key here. It forces me to make a decision. Oh. That's not the way to go. Do this with tempo because. Oh, wait. Wait a second. Oh, wait, no, this is fine. I was gonna say rook e1 ruins my day. But it actually does. Yeah. Alright, so. It was well spotted. This should be a draw. No, don't move the. Well, as long as my king and my rook pawn don't get separated, I'm fine. How's this go again? Check. All right. Well played. I don't think he could have won that. I'm pretty sure I did not blow that endgame badly enough to lose it. Consult your table base if you have a differing opinion, because I'm pretty sure on that one I'm correct. His king is just too far displaced to stop my king and pawn. Got something that resembles a dragon without knight c6. Oh, there's knight c6. Right. Oh, right. Here's the move. Queen e1. I forgot about that. Why didn't I play that the other game? But yeah, this is, I guess I'll say it's a cousin of the dragon. Wait. Am I supposed to take? Well, if I don't take, I'm getting forked, so I have to take. I have to take that. And he does get a pretty imposing center. But I don't know. I think this is fine for white. I'm attacking e5 and d5. So I guess what? Queen c7 or something? No, that doesn't save this. Yeah, how does black get out of this tactic? Does black get out of this tactic? Do I need to start playing some slower games? Oh, my opponent disconnected. Probably not by choice. Okay, he's back. Still, I think my position's good here. He's got a hanging center, and most of his pieces are still on his back rank. I guess the same could be said for my pieces. Neither one of us is better developed than the other, but let's see, bishop takes, knight takes, bishop takes. Yeah, that doesn't work. So the only way that works is queen takes. But if queen takes, then knight e4. And then bishop takes queen. That's okay. So I think I win the pawn. Do I go back? If I go back, tactics are not my friend, but they aren't my friend anyhow. I guess I go back this way, right? There's knight e4. I was gonna do queen g3. Then I stopped to think about it. And we're gonna settle on queen f4 instead. He might end up playing d4. Oh. Okay, do I accept another gambit? How many gambits am I going to accept before I find a way to lose this? I don't think I can take that one. what else do I do? Okay, I'm just gonna develop. I'm starting to think that taking that pawn was not my wisest move. And allowing this kind of tactic wizardry was also pretty bad. So let's just get my king out of here. It's abundantly clear that I have not played this correctly. Oh, look, I'm giving up a rook. Hopefully I get something for it. Okay, first he goes for the mate. Makes sense. Wait, where's the mate? I'm not seeing. Oh, there it is. I forgot. It's right there. I knew I saw a mate there for a second, and I'm like, where'd it go? But yeah, I'm sacking an exchange here. Not a whole rook anymore. I still hope I get something for it. Oh dear. I seem to be playing with fire today. Thankfully, his discoveries don't kill me. This could be a lot worse. That's not good. So if king f2, he takes my rook, I take back, he takes back, I take back. I'm still in this game, surprisingly. Because this rook on e8's hanging, it takes him a tempo to get somewhere. With that tempo, I can not hang my bishop on d3. That's kind of a mess, isn't it? I didn't say this is a good endgame, but I'm still hanging in here somehow. If he drops material, then maybe I've got something, but in all likelihood, I'm just in deep trouble. That's not so hot for me. Do I push? Do I go queen f8 and throw it all away? No, we're gonna draw. I guess I'll claim a draw. I was still thinking even after I said we're gonna draw, because both of us had the option to keep playing and to try to win it. But yeah, he had the better chances in that position, so I just let us draw. gonna see d4. Yeah, here's the stuff. Except he played bishop d2. Yeah, the fun stuff happens if you gambit the pawn with what's it? Knight c3 instead of bishop c2, d2. I guess we'll save the fun stuff for another day. All right, now how's Black supposed to play this? I'm trying to remember. Is it queen b5? That seems kind of forced. Maybe b6 might be okay. Yeah, no, b6, b4, I have to go back, and then c6 drops, so it looks like this is forced. So we both lost castling ability in this situation. I could castle the other way. Oopsie daisy. Okay. Now we get some fun. Crud. Yeah, so if I don't find anything, I'm cooked here. Do I have anything? Knight c4, knight takes. Doesn't cut it. Well, we can try. Yeah, I know this is actually a pretty depressing position the more I look at it. So I've got a rook for a queen. He can't castle. But I've got something that might be able to be held. Oh. Oh, that's no good. Let's try this. I guess he just plays rook e1. I take, he takes. I play my rook to e8. It's not so hot. So we'll do this. Let's go back, because going forward loses the bishop on the spot. I'm still getting my bishop trapped. Do I have an answer to that? The answer might be resignation. Because now he just throws in rook b1, and I can't stop that. I can't allow his knight to check me with tempo. So. All right. I guess if I'm trying to hold this, I play rook there. And I guess I start chomping pawns. So what else am I to do here? King's gonna dodge for the corner. Just keep some distance between the king and the rook, and hopefully there won't be a fork. If I do manage to trade enough pawns, maybe I'll have some opportunities to save this. So just keep chomping. Let's see. I have to go this way. The other way loses the rook instantly. I appear to be losing the rook in any event. Wait, no. If knight b6, I have to king a7. I'm not forced to walk into the fork. Okay. Is there any way I can hold this? I've been making this interesting for some time, but it looks like my reign is finally ending. Yeah, there's no way to salvage this. You got me. He finally managed to hunt down my king and take it. So that was well done. So with that, he's got a win, and I think we've got two draws between us. We got another Sicilian coming up. I'm guessing we're getting another dragon. And hopefully this time, I will be less greedy. E5 is the move he played. I think E5 does seem right. It just seems weird. Because it forces me to go for this. And here's where I've actually got some decision-making ability, and last time this didn't go so well. Let's try it this way. So rather than opening up the center, we're going to try to leave it as it is. This is kind of really odd, but I think it looks okay. Get to keep my preserve my bishops. A lot more difficult for me to develop that bishop. Did I play knight a3? Bishop takes b3. Maybe. Let's try it. I guess queen a... No, I didn't have queen a5, because his queen could go to a5. So maybe I've got bishop c4 here. Okay, I did not expect that. That seems kind of risky. I love grabbing material. So I'll take it. If you could play queen a5 and keep the queens on the board instead of trading them, that'd be one thing. I guess I have to play b4 here. So I've got a bishop for two pawns, and my king is wide open. Not everybody takes those odds, understandably. Okay, do I play king up? So, I've got two pieces defending this. My knight actually helps in the defense. Meanwhile, all my pieces are just sitting here on the back rank, looking, I don't know, ineffective. And now we unwind. So this displaces the queen. So the queen can't both attack c4 and f6. I think I'm losing this. Pretty sure I'm losing this. Oh, maybe I should have done queen takes b4. I'm pretty sure that was the key here. So this is forced. Okay. If I take that, I'm getting mated, so this is forced. Yeah, queen takes b4 in hindsight, trading a queen for a couple pieces seems like not such a big deal. This is a really interesting series here, but I seem to be getting crushed. Okay. Oh, that does force mate. Is there any avoiding it? No. Well done. Well done. Okay, we'll give him a rematch. I think I had him there if I just had done queen takes b4. I was just too greedy material-wise. Okay, well, we're gonna play a Grunfeld. Or at least attempt to transpose into one. I'm not sure in what opening territory we've landed. Really depends what gets exchanged and what stays on the board. And a lot of that's still kind of up in the air. Okay. I step out of this threat from your bishop. So now we've landed in some kind of territory which almost resembles a Grunfeld, except, well, he doesn't have a pawn on e4. So maybe in this particular opening, it's a thing for me to play f6 and e5. Just given that I have the opportunity, shouldn't I use it? Knight takes, pawn takes, pawn takes, knight takes, bishop takes. Oh wait, the bishop's not taking that. But yeah, f6 and e5 seems too hasty here. Let's kick this bishop. I suspect he's just going to go back there to h4. I'm not sure what to do. I guess we'll prepare e5, but I still am of the opinion I can't instantly play it. All right. Where does my knight want to go? Think it's aiming for e4 still. So we've done all these weird maneuvers. And my knight still just wants to go to the normal square of e4. Okay. Oh, now he's got bishop g3. But that doesn't decide anything. Do I just leave that there? No, he's threatening knight c6. So I have to do something. I think this was just a cheapo to hit the A pawn. I'm sure he wants to move his B pawn with tempo, but moving the B pawn actually opens this diagonal, so that might not be something he actually wants to do. My bishop's not so hot, so of course I'll trade it. Almost had time to play g5. I could play it here. We do get some imbalances. But winning the bishop's not worth that headache. It's not worth disrupting my entire position just to get the bishop for knight. Especially when I can get interesting play here instead. Finally, e5 happens. And we see that this queen is, in fact, offsides. He's going to play g4. This is messy. He might play g4. It might not be good. It's scary, but it might not be good. Alright. I've got to bail out of this. Just get some kind of end game and play it. Was that a mouse slip? Did he intend queen b6, I wonder? There's nothing to do about it now, but have to play this to defend my knight. Oh, crap. Forgot. Lots of stuff is hanging. All right, we got an end game, guys. Hopefully I've got the better side of it. What a mess. No, I had Rook A2. Still have Rook A2. I'm playing it. I successfully complicated this. Though it's not really complicated after all. I have to take this. Yeah, fine, we'll take a draw. My position's no better there. That was too bad. Let's play in English. I'm tired of getting ground down in that dragon. I'm not learning anything anyhow, other than I just can't calculate as fast as I need to win that. Assuming, in fact, I had a winning position at some point, and maybe I didn't. That's a fun little maneuver. You want to move your queen back to the other side now? We'll just take some space. No big deal. I mean, unless I'm missing something, this is decent for me. Possibly much better than decent. This is like a Benoni, maybe. Benoni being where I play my pawns to e4 and d5. Except here, I don't have an e-pawn to worry about. My e-pawn actually supports my knight. And if he pushes his pawn, his position's really loose. That's dangerous. It's really double-edged for him. So I'm just going to support this. Meanwhile, he's got this huge gaping weakness on d6. So if I just have a tempo, my kingdom for a tempo, I'm doing awesome. And if I don't have a tempo, I'm probably dead. So we'll see how it plays out. Yeah, he doesn't have knight takes d5 because I got knight takes. If he does knight g4, I just do knight c takes e4. Oh, that's clever. Okay, so I won a pawn. Mission accomplished. We're going home. Yeah, I play on whatever site chooses not to time me out for. I don't know. It just wasn't accepting my moves. So, oops, I got distracted. I was dead anyhow, but is he gonna spot it? No, he misses that my knight's hanging. Or he's really kind and chooses not to take it. I'm gonna guess it was the latter. But yeah, Lee Chess was just not accepting my moves, and I was running out of time. So, here I am. this king look safe or what? This happens when I go pawn hunting. Horrible, horrible things happen to my king. Things that should never happen in a million years. Alright, so if bishop takes bishop. Wait a minute. There's a third path here, isn't there? Okay. Bishop takes, queen takes, king over. I mean, I'm sure he throws a knight takes f3 at some point. I am ultra super confused by this play. Bishop takes, queen take, or knight takes, pawn takes, queen takes, king over. I don't get it. You're going to have to show me, because I am not following this. So I'm up a bishop. I guess he's got queen takes g3. I've got knight there. I think I'm okay. Pretty sure I'm surviving this. I guess what he missed, he saw queen takes g3 and he was expecting there to be a mate or something. Oh, I can't take that. Well, I have to take it. If I don't, he just takes on e1. And he doesn't take my rook. Is he okay? He was playing some awesome chess the last few games, and now he's just rolling over this game. Well, I'm way up in materials, so I'm going to start trading down. I'm guessing the fact that he's located in Europe, and it must be late over there. It's probably got something to do with the fact that I just won tons of material. So let's just defend that. And just plunk the knight on e6. Plunk it there anyway. And I'm sure there's a rule that if you just put all your pieces on good squares, you just can declare victory. That's a rule, right? Say, oh yeah, I'm winning, I declare victory. If not, that should be a rule, because it would save some of this embarrassing stuff. I stop. Well, it doesn't stop rook c7. Rook c7's already stopped by the knight. I stop him from taking my pawn. Oops, don't want to do that. Goodness. Okay, I threaten mate. Go ahead, take my rook. You're forcing me to play really incisive moves. Gotta defend like this. Yeah, and I'm not sure what to do. A1, I just take it. Let's go back. Alright, he does concede one. I sense that he's tired. He wants a rematch. I will accept that, although I think he's probably suffering from sleep deprivation at some point. But yeah, we'll take it. Okay. There we go. Now we're back into this, the Slav. How do I play this? I'm gonna provoke c5. I have a feeling that provoking c5 is bad strategically. He's not playing it. Okay. So I'll just shuffle like this. I guess c5 wasn't necessary after all. You could just play a5. Whoa, why that move? What's the point, buddy? You haven't stopped me from breaking, so I will break. Bishop b2 would stop my break and really force me to rethink my life choices with this opening. Bishop a3, on the other hand, says go right ahead and dares me to break. And, I mean, I do. And now I'm winning material. Not very much, but I'm winning some. There's a fork. Well, that's messy. So, he's gonna take, or I'm sorry, he's gonna fork me. I'm gonna take one of his things, and he's gonna take my rook. I don't really have a choice in the matter, because I've committed this far. I've committed everything to this attack. So there's no going back here. Which piece do I want more? I want this bishop. Yep, that's a fork. Play this innocuous move. Actually threatening bishop there, skewering that, so yeah, he had to play his rook over. And I'm not sure where to go next. I've got knight b8, allowing bishop f5. I don't like it. This is another way to develop my knight. Yeah, I definitely have some dark square, or rather light square weaknesses. I'm confused as to where my weakness is. But I do have a weakness somewhere. I'm just not seeing it. C6 doesn't look too strong. So let's just keep developing and hope that I get some counterplay somewhere. Queen c4, bishop e6, and b3 is loose. Yes, he can take c6. I mean, he was gonna be able to mop that up anyway. There's no need to do it with tempo. Right. Do I take there? Does a queen trade help me? I'm down material, so queen trade is not something to aim for. I have just as much pressure without immediately trading as I do with the immediate trade. See, now I trade because I'm winning a. No, I'm. Yeah, I am. I'm winning a pawn. So I've restored material equality. This endgame is still pretty terrible. But I'm doing okay. I guess just mentally. position's not so hot, but in terms of just cosmetically being able to attack things and stir up some kind of play, I've got some of that going here. It's not enough to compensate for all what everything I'm gonna have to deal with, but it's definitely not nothing. Yeah, no, I understand I'm in time pressure. I am more than aware of that. Ooh. That's not pretty. Oh crap, that's gonna drop F7. F7's dropping, so I'm gonna do it with tempo if I can. Oh, he trades a rook for two. That's not good. Okay, let's push. I have no time to think. No time whatsoever. Free pawn. Maybe I can provoke the rook to a bad square. Maybe knight c4 happens opportunistically. Probably not. Oops, that's no good, so I'll put it here instead. We'll hit that. Although I missed knight e4, although it didn't work, so missing it's not such a big deal. Is he gonna pin me? No, he misses the pin. And now I have chances. We're gonna break that up. To keep my knight near my other pieces, lest I just drop the knight accidentally. Yeah, no, I'm not taking a draw. I'm gonna win this. I'll find a way. he appreciated my playing it out to the end like that, but I have managed to level our match score between the two of us, and hopefully I've managed to earn myself a break here. Because I forget how long I've been going here. Yeah, no, he's left. Yeah, he played well. Obviously, it was wrong for him to blunder the material, but blunders happen quite frequently in Blitz. If he hadn't blundered, I guess, yeah, earlier I was saying that this position was pretty terrible. At this point, it's not as terrible. He's failed to activate his king. His bishop's on the edge of the board. I've got a passed pawn. Here, with best play by white, this probably is going to be a draw in Blitz conditions. Under a standard game time control, I'm not sure how this would play out. It's probably still a draw if black can manage to take this d pawn. And yeah, you can. It's no big deal to take this. A little bit earlier, well, I guess what really broke white's position was that he just kept pushing this pawn in the center. And he needed to focus on developing his pieces and not putting all his pawns on the same color square as his bishop. Because having everything on one color of square means my knight can dance around pretty easily and make threats everywhere. Just as a practical matter, there's no dealing with that in a blitz game. If these instead were on h3, g2, e2, d3, this would be very difficult for black to form any kind of threat because the pawns would cover all the light squares and the bishop would stop all the checks on the dark squares. And so white would pretty easily be able to march his king up, and once the king's in position, either chop the a pawn or push the d pawn and promote it. Or say if I committed all my resources to trying to push on the side or stop the d pawn, then if I commit everything to the queen side, then he can just mop up on the king side. But yeah, we had some interesting blitz games, that's for sure. I haven't had this kind of challenge in a long time, and I know I've been playing a lot of Lee Chess, but people on Lee Chess, I don't know. They aren't posing this kind of theoretical stuff. I guess there is one exception, and that's whenever some strong players on Lee Chess decide to start hosting a ladder. Those types of competitive events really bring out theoretical knowledge and skill. But on a day-to-day basis, when I play on Lee Chess, it's just who hangs a piece, and that's what happens. And I'm really liking this kind of challenge, although it's exhausting and leaves me no time whatsoever to interact with you guys. But yeah, this is fun. Anyhow, well, I guess maybe on Lee Chess I start doing more like simuls or tactics or other stuff. Because, yeah, just playing games in the lobby and playing in tournaments hasn't been especially fulfilling. Other than the big events, but those have been exhausting. Because usually the pairings aren't anywhere close. But yeah, I'll think more about it and see what I can do. But this is looking like a pretty promising alternative if I can just make this look a lot nicer. And I'm sure I could find some way to do that. Anyhow, hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Thanks for sticking around. And with that, I'm gonna take a break. So have a good one, and see you next time.